In this week's highlights, US sanctions waivers on importing Iranian oil expire, the potential restart of a key Russian oil pipeline is eyed, and European petrochemical contract prices for May are expected to rise. One of the main focuses this week for the oil markets will be Thursday's expiry of US sanctions waivers for countries which are major importers of Iranian crude oil. These include China, India, Japan, and closer to home, Turkey. The White House is demanding those countries abide by US sanctions and refuse to extend the waivers. The US has said Iran's regional rivals, Saudi Arabia and the United Arab Emirates, will make up the supply shortfall. In response, Iran has threatened to shut down the Strait of Hormuz, a key choke point in the tanker shipping lanes in the Persian Gulf, and warned Saudi Arabia and the UAE not to take its market share. The rise in the oil price caused by the US sanctions on Iran and Venezuela, as well as the collapse of Venezuelan oil output, should be welcomed by Europe's oil companies, you might think. Several report their first quarter results this week, including BP, Shell, and Norway's Equinor. But Total sounded a cautious note in its results on Friday about greater volatility in oil markets. On the subject of choke points, European oil market participants will be monitoring updates on Russia's progress on getting one of the largest oil pipeline systems in the world, Druzhba, up and running again. The indications so far are that supplies could be back to normal in the first 10 days of May. The 1 million barrel a day pipeline feeds 20 refineries in European countries, including Germany and Poland, as well as the Ust-Luga terminal for seaborne exports of Russia's benchmark crude grade Urals. The shutdown is due to contamination issues which started before Easter. Supply of sour crudes like Urals is already tight in Europe, and the disruption is expected to prompt refiners to scramble for sure bet replacement Urals cargoes from the Baltic port of Primorsk and Novorossiysk on the Black Sea, adding yet more support to the record high prices of the last several months. And speaking of depending on Russia, top EU and US officials will meet in Brussels Thursday to promote US LNG exports to Europe. The European Commission is keen to see the US become a major gas supplier to Europe to help reduce the EU's reliance on Russian gas. This takes us to our social media question. What's your view on US LNG becoming an increasing supply of European gas? Tweet us your thoughts with the hashtag PlattsMM. But before that, the EU's deadline for companies to verify their CO2 emissions for the previous year arrives on Tuesday. Companies must ensure their carbon allowances match their emissions. As you can see from the chart on your screen, EU carbon allowances surged to an 11-year high earlier in April. Now, some believe prices could suffer a short-term dip following a drop-off in demand once the deadline passes. Staying with large carbon dioxide emitters, the outcome of elections in Spain last weekend might unsettle metals markets. The new government is expected to look at the creation of a new statute for large energy consumers, with steel and other metals plants firmly in the spotlight. The auto sector is also expected to be affected. And finally, European petrochemical markets will be watching out for industry-settled contract prices for May this week. Prices are expected to rise as a result of various outages at plants across Europe, as well as higher prices for feedstock naphtha. Thanks for kicking off your week with us, and have a great week ahead.